Well, I began making an answer key for tonight's homework and thought you might need a little extra help to get started. So here I am with you to help you out. So what we are going to do in this first problem here is we are going to use Euler's method. Let's just read it. For problems 3 and 4 on the previous page. Now we're going to look at when y was 1 and x was 1. Because actually on the previous page, on problem number 3, they told us to look specifically at 1, 1, and then they also told us to look at the point negative 2, 0. So we're just going to focus on the solution function that goes through 1, 1. We're going to use Euler's method, and we're going to find the value when x equals negative 1. So we're going to take a numerical approach to find the solution when x equals negative 1. And we're going to go 2 steps of equal size. So we're starting off, if I were to make a little xy table, we're starting off at 1, 1, and then we want to end up at negative 1 and find out the y value. Well, what do you notice is the change in value there in the x values? Well, we notice the difference between 1 and negative 1, we're actually going down 2, okay? So if I want to take 2 steps of equal size, if I divide negative 2 by 2, that means my change in x, we're going to change by negative 1 unit. So we're going to take 2 steps. So we'll go down 1 the first time, and then go down 1 the second time. And then that will give us an estimate of the y value when x is negative 1. So according to our notes in class today, we're going to start off with the ordered pair, okay? So the ordered pair that's given is 1, 1. And now we're going to use our slope to find the derivative. So according to this problem number 3, the derivative function was negative x over y. So if I take the opposite of 1 is negative 1, so negative 1 over 1 is negative 1, okay? Now the change in x, we're going to decrease by 1, okay? And our change in y, we know that that is the derivative times the change in x, okay? So that would be negative 1 times negative 1, so that means the change in y will be positive 1. So our new point on this function is the x value is going to change by a negative 1. So that means if I change by a negative 1, my new x value will be 0. And my y value is going to change by 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So the new point on the graph is 0, 2. Now I'm going to continue. So now if I have 0, 2, and I use the same steps, so I take the x value over the y value, well, that is a change of 0. Now we're going to decrease by negative 1 again because our hope is to get to when x is negative 1. And now I multiply the change in x times the derivative, and I get 0. So that means my new x value is negative 1, but I do not change for the 0 value, so it is negative 1, 2. So this is our approximation, that if I start at 1, 1, then my next point would be negative 1, 2. Now what I want you to do is go back and look at the slope field and look at the function that you drew on number 3. So number 3, kind of a rough sketch of number 3, is you had these slopes and you had these slopes. So when you drew in, let me use a different color here to make it pretty snazzy. At 1, 1, when I drew in my function using the slope fields, I kind of got basically a circle. Did you also? So then this is saying approximately at negative 1 up 2, that should be the approximate point. And yes, it does match my graphical solution. So the numerical solution matches the graphical solution. Okay, now you do number 4 in the same method, in that you're going to start with the point 1, 1 and do your change in x in 2 steps and predict what the new point would be for x is negative 1. Now, if I scroll down a little bit, I'm also going to do this problem with you because this math actually gets quite complex. So for problems 1 and 2 on the previous page, we're going to look at the point again, 1, 1, and we're going to actually find the solution function using an algebraic approach. So notice we did a numerical, now we're going to do an algebraic approach. Okay, so the function they give us, the differential function is dy over dx is equal to y. So I have to separate, integrate, integrate, and add a c. Okay, so first thing I need to do is I'm going to separate. So I'm going to have dy over dx. Wait, no, I'm going to move the dx right over. Okay. So I have dy is going to equal y times dx. Now I still have to divide by y. So I have 1 over y dy is equal to dx. So I separate it. Now I'm going to have to integrate. So I integrate both sides, and the integral and the derivative undo each other. So I'm left with 1 over y. The integral of dx is x plus c. Don't forget the c. Okay. So there we have it. 1 over y. Oh, no, 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 I made a mistake. The integral of 1 over y can't be 1 over y. Do you guys remember what the integral of 1 over y is? It's special, because remember, if we try to use the power rule, 1 over y is negative 1, and if we add 1, we'd get y over 0 over 0. Well, you can't divide by 0. So this had a special antiderivative. It was the natural log of the absolute value of y. Woohoo! There we go. Okay, now I'm given a point, 1, 1. So I'm going to use that point to find the value of c. So the natural log of 1 is equal to 1 plus c. Well, what is the natural log of 1? That means e to what power is 1? Well, it's 0. So we know c has a value of negative 1. Okay? So I can go back up and replace c with the negative 1. So my function is the natural log of y equals x minus 1. Okay? Now, using this, I need to predict. Remember, the whole goal is to find out what is the function when x is negative 1. So I want to find out what's the y value when x is negative 1. So natural log of y is equal to negative 1 minus 1. So the natural log of y, negative 2. Okay? Oh, my word. How do I undo natural log? Well, if you remember, you have to take it e to the power, and so now I get y, and of course this will be a positive value. If you put it in your calculator, it's approximately 0.135. So now go back and look at the graphical approach, the slope field. When you drew in the graph through the point 1, 1, at negative 1, would you have approximately gotten 0.135? Now I did, because I had an exponential function going on, and that fit just perfectly. So see, the algebraic approach should support the numerical approach, and if I used Euler's method also would support it. Now you do the other two problems. How do I stop this video? Oh, there it is.